Let's go live to Reece D'Alessandro, at the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital. Reece, confirmation tonight of who will take over as Queensland's new Chief Health Officer.
Yeah, that's right, Melissa. This announcement has been long expected, but today it finally arrived. In just under 4 weeks' time, Dr. Jeanette Young will be the old Chief Health Officer, and confirmation today on who our new CHO is here in Queensland. He is the Director of the Infectious Diseases Unit here at the Royal Brisbane Hospital. His job going forward, though, will be bringing life in the Sunshine State back to normal. Queensland's new general in our war on COVID, Dr. Krispin Hajkowicz.
Dr. Hajkowicz, and then say a few words.
It had some stumped, but it's a name we'll be hearing a lot of from now on.
My name's Krispin Hajkowicz. I'm a clinical infectious diseases specialist.
At the Royal Brisbane Hospital, leading the treatment of more than 200 COVID cases, working across Queensland and interstate, he's from a clinical background with experience from other, perhaps less memorable, pandemics.
Including the 2009 flu pandemic, Ebola, and do I pronounce it Zika? Zika, yep.
The father of three is no stranger to driving the message home.
Either everyone can get COVID and get immunity that way, or much better, everyone can get vaccinated.
The recruitment process started in July. The search to replace Dr. Jeanette Young, a difficult one, given she's been in the role more than 16 years.
Now, I've been going to him for the last 2 years for advice. He has been the lead in the treatment and management of COVID cases.
With a new phase of the pandemic fast approaching, both doctors Young and Hajkowicz agree frontline experience treating coronavirus will be crucial in the months ahead.
That's the right time to have a clinical lead coming into the pandemic at this moment, where we're going to have a shift and we're going to be treating cases in hospital.
He'll take over from November 1 when Dr. Young becomes Governor of Queensland, stopping short today of answering the tough questions like, will the borders reopen at 80% fully vaccinated?
I'm not the CHO yet, so I'm looking forward to asking those very valid questions, but I'm not the CHO yet, and I'll look forward to answering them when I do become the CHO.
But he agrees the time to transition to living with COVID is fast approaching. Reece D'Alessandro, Nine News.